Welcome back, my dear students of class 10th. And as in the previous video, you have learned about the sexual reproduction, the first step of the sexual reproduction. The first step of the sexual reproduction was, if you recall, that was the gametogenesis. Either in plant or in animal, in both, whether they are small plants, small animals, or big plants and big animals. Now, my dear students, the sexual reproduction is the process where you understand the processes of the sexual reproduction in plants, in animals, and in human itself. Dear student, in the next step, in this video, you are going to learn the process of the sexual reproduction in plants. My dear student, as you know, the plants are of several types: algae, bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. My dear students, the plants having the flowers are grouped into the angiosperms. So let us see about the sexual reproduction in flowering plant. And in this process, in plants, in this process of the sexual reproduction, first of all, you have the some views on the sexual reproduction in plants, viewing the structure of the flower. My dear students, since last classes you are learning about the structure of the flower, so recall the structure of the flower, structure of the bisexual flower. My dear students, flowers are of two types. Number one, that is unisexual, and number two, that is bisexual. Unisexual and bisexual, two types of flowering plants are there. Now let us see the structure of the bisexual flower. The structure of the bisexual flower is having sepal, petal, calyx, and corolla. Androecium and gynoecium means female part and male part, that is present inside a flower. So let us see a structure of the flower. And that is, this structure is, having something like this. This is the base of the flower. This is the base of the flower, and calyx and corolla, sepal and petal. Sepal and petal. This is sepal. Sepal. This is petal. Petal. In other words, this is called calyx and this is called corolla. So two words are there. Two names are there. Calyx and corolla, or you can say sepal and petal. And this is the base. From the base there is a centrally located female reproductive part, which is called gynoecium. This female reproductive part is called gynoecium, or one other name is also there, that is this is stigma, stigma. This is style. This is ovary. Ovary. And in this ovary, there is a long pollen tube. There is a long pollen tube inside this style, inside this gynoecium, and this pollen tube is for the passage of the pollen grain. This is for the passage of the pollen grain, and the pollen grain, when it comes into the stigma, it travels towards the this pollen tube, and it reaches to the ovary. It reaches to the ovary where ovules are there. These are the ovules. Ovules. Ovules are there inside the ovary. This is the ovary, and these are the ovules. Ovules. My dear students, this is the female part of the flower, and this female part is called gynoecium, which is divided into the ovary, style, and stigma. These three parts combinedly called gynoecium. And male part, which is also present inside it, inside this flower, the male part is androecium. The male part is called androecium. Male part is called androecium. So androecium is having this is filament, this is anther, and combinedly it is called androecium. And combinedly this is called gynoecium. So gynoecium is the female part and androecium is the male part of the bisexual flower. Suppose this is the flower of the hibiscus rosa sinensis or mustard, then the structure will be something like this. If you see in LS of flower, if you see the LS of flower, LS means longitudinal section. If you cut the flower longitudinally, then you will see the structure like gynoecium, which is having stigma, style, and ovary. Ovary is having ovules, and this gynoecium is supplied by the pollen tube. This is pollen tube. So my dear student, by this video you will be able to learn, if you practice this diagram along with this teaching video, then you will be able to learn all the parts, all the key points of this structural organization of the flower of a bisexual plant. Bisexual means both sexes are present inside a compact structure inside a flower, while unisexual means either androecium will be present or gynoecium will be present. That is the unisexual. Bisexual, both present. Unisexual, only one present, either male part present or female part present. Dear student, in this androecium and gynoecium, what you have learned in the previous video about the gametogenesis takes place in the androecium and gynoecium. And gametogenesis, which results the formation of male gamete and female gamete. So androecium produce मेल गैमेट, मेल गैमेट एंड गायरोसोम प्रोड्यूस फीमेल गैमेट, फीमेल गैमेट, मेल का फीमेल गैमेट इज द ओव्यूल, दिस इज ओव्यूल प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय गायनोसियम एंड दिस इज पॉलन ग्रेन, पॉलन ग्रेन प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय एंडोसियम एज मेल गैमेट, एज मेल गैमेट. So male gamete and female gamete get produced by a bisexual flower in the process of the sexual reproduction in that plant. And when these pollen grains and ovule get matured, then the process of pollination takes place. So you have to see the structural organization of bisexual flower in this video. As well as you have to learn about the transfer of the pollen grains from this anther to stigma, and that process is called pollination. Therefore, let us see the structure of this androecium. In the androecium, dear student, in the androecium you will see the structure something like this, and this is the tetrad. It forms a tetrad, and in this tetrad, four nuclei are there. Four pollen grains are there. This is anther. This is anther, which is having the pollen grains. Pollen grains. The individual structure of this pollen grain is like. Something like this. This is exyme. This is intyme. And this is nuclei. These are the nuclei which are responsible for the fusion of the pollen grains with the ovule. My dear students, if you see the structure of this ovule, then you will find the structure of an ovule. That is, ovule means oval structure, and this ovule is having central nuclei. Terminal nuclei, these nuclei are responsible for the fusion with the pollen nuclei. So these are the nuclei means nucleus. My dear students, when this in the next process, when the flower get matured, the ovule get matured, and the pollen grain get matured, then the process of pollination takes place. Pollination takes place, and it is of two types: self pollination, and cross pollination. And you are well aware about the media of the pollination, that human can pollinate the flower, insect can pollinate the flower, wind can pollinate the flower, insect can pollinate the flower. And one thing is very important, that the color of this petal
is too attractive so that the human, insects, other animals attract towards it. Attract towards it. Because it is having the attractive color. All the flowers are having the attractive color, and the purpose of this attractive color is the pollination only. Attractive color and fragrance, good fragrance, these are the factors for the pollination. Attractive color and good fragrance are the factors for the pollination, so that insect can attract towards it and the process of pollination takes place. Human can touch it and the process of pollination takes place. How this pollination takes place? My dear students, when the pollen grain gets matured, pollen grain gets matured inside this anther, then they will be able to transfer, from anther towards the stigma, and from stigma these pollen grains travel inside the pollen tube and they will be able to reach towards the ovule. And in the next process, after pollination, in the next process, fertilization takes place. Fertilization takes place. So, fertilization can be defined as the fusion of the pollen nuclei with the ovule nuclei. Fusion of the pollen grain nuclei and ovule nuclei is called fertilization. And this fertilization is external. This is the internal fertilization inside this flower, bisexual flower. And after fertilization, the formation of seed takes place. The formation of seed means this ovule get converted into the seed, and seed get developed inside this ovary in the form of seed. So my dear students, this is the structure of flower, bisexual flower, and the structure of pollen grain, ovule. In this video, you will be able to learn very carefully, and male gamete formation and female gamete formation, pollination, self-pollination. Self-pollination means if the pollen grain transfers from the anther towards its own stigma. Same flower or same plant, that is called the self-pollination. While if the pollen grain transfer from a flower to another flower or to another plant's flower, then that is called the cross-pollination. Cross means cross to each other. Cross in between the plants, cross in between the flowers. And self means, that is the self-pollination means self within the plant or self within the flower. So you have to clear about the self and cross-pollination. And my dear student, in the next video, you will be able to learn about the process of fertilization, formation of seed, germination of seed, etc. Thank you very much for watching this video.